In this video, we're computing the first derivative of e to the sine pi x. And this is actually a function of a function of a function. So the first thing we have is e to this power. And we differentiate with respect to that power. So differentiating e to the sine pi x with respect to sine pi x means we treat that exponent as a single variable for a moment, and we just get e to the sine pi x, because e to the x is equal to its own derivative. Next, we tack on the derivative of the exponent. And because that's a composite function, I'm going to slow things down and just write sine pi x prime, which just means I have to differentiate that thing in the next step. So to get the derivative of sine pi x, I differentiate sine of pi x with respect to pi x. And that simply gives me a cosine of pi x. And then the chain rule says I have to tack on the derivative of pi x with respect to x, which gives me another factor of pi. And just cleaning things up a little, I get pi cosine pi x e to the sine pi x, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.